New details tonight in the murder of a Kansas City, Kansas woman. Tonight, 46-year-old Timothy Webb is charged with killing his girlfriend, then fleeing in her roommate's car. He is still on the loose tonight. And now, the roommate who discovered the victim's body describes a series of events leading up to that murder that has taken on new meaning. KMBC 9's Peggy Breit is live now at KCK Police Headquarters. Peggy?
Well, Kelly, less than 2 weeks ago, the murder victim invited her longtime friend and co-worker to move in with her to help share on some of the bills. But what Lori, the roommate, didn't know is that the hot-tempered boyfriend was part of the package.
He had the anger to where he would toss things around and he would project his voice really loud.
Lori says fighting in this home was regular. In the 10 days she lived here, she says police had been called 2 or 3 times. Then yesterday morning, Lori found 45-year-old Sharon Nero dead.
I never did see her get physical, but I have seen him threaten her. I want to say it's basically his jealousy and her insecurity.
Lori says Sharon was concerned about Lori's relationship with the boyfriend, but Lori says she had just met him when she moved in, would not have betrayed Sharon, and was not interested in him despite his advances. In fact, Lori says she was actually developing a fear of him.
He was with Sharon. They were only together for like 6 months, but then by his behavior and his way he did things, he would have other women on the side too, but it wasn't me though.
Then on Tuesday night, Lori says Sharon and her boyfriend started fighting again. Lori left to avoid seeing it. She returned with a friend just before midnight, only to be met at the door by the boyfriend.
Like when I opened up the screen door, he was right there at the door already. He asked me, Lori, can I borrow your car? I told him my car was on empty, the light's already on, it's not gonna go nowhere. And he's like, well, I'll put gas in it and kind of push, or grabbed for my keys and then just ran out quick.
Lori says when she steps inside the house, she saw Sharon lying on the couch, but she thought she was sleeping. We'll have the rest of that story coming up for you tonight on our News at 6. We're live at KCK Police Headquarters. Back to you in the studio, Kelly.
All right. Thank you, Peggy. Now, Lori's car is still missing along with Webb. He is said to have relatives in this area as well as in Texas and Louisiana. Lori's missing car is a 2004 Chevy Malibu four-door. It is gold with tinted windows and has Missouri tags UG1P3W. If you have information, you are urged to call the TIPS hotline, 816-474-TIPS.